Hey there guys, glad to have you back here for another class. Today we have an easy but rewarding lesson. We're going to go over installing the official PIVX mobile wallet on your phone. This wallet can be a great, safe, and secure way to store your PIV. It even includes multiple backup functionalities to help prevent the loss of your PIV. The only drawback is that it does not allow you to stake or run a masternode. One important thing to note is that at the time of making this video, this wallet is not available for iPhones, but is expected to release in quarter one of 2018. So if you are watching this after March, it probably is available. The steps should be nearly the same as what you see in this video, except that you will use the Apple App Store. All right, let's begin. First, open up the Play Store. Now search for PIVX Wallet. Click the one that looks like this one in the top left here. Confirm that it comes from Furzy. He's the developer who made the wallet. After it is done downloading, open it up. You'll be greeted by the PIVX Panther, our mascot. If the sound effect isn't to your preference, you can turn it off in the settings. You'll then see a welcome screen that will give you some highlights of why the wallet is a good wallet to use. You may flip through this or skip it, whatever works for you. Now we'll come to a screen where you can restore an old wallet or create a new one. Of course, we'll be choosing Create a New Wallet. Just like a bank card, this wallet utilizes a PIN code to keep your money safe. Choose one that you can remember, but can't be guessed. It's good to avoid using any birthdays or numbers that are publicly available. Next, you'll be presented with a long string of words like these. This is your mnemonic backup phrase. This is a pretty cool feature to take advantage of. If you ever lose your wallet, even the phone it is on, you can use this phrase on another device to get your wallet back. You should write this down on a piece of paper and put it somewhere very safe. If you have a safety deposit box, that's a great place. Otherwise, just keep it somewhere where others won't find it. It would be good to include your PIN code and the upcoming password on that paper as well. You'll now be prompted to make a backup. This one is different from the last one. It is a digital backup. It is easier to use than entering in that paper code manually. If you click OK and give it a password to use, it will store a backup on your device. If anything ever happens to your wallet, like it becomes corrupted, you accidentally delete it, or anything like that, you can easily access that backup to restore your wallet like nothing ever happened. You can copy that backup off of your phone if you like, but make sure to keep it somewhere safe like you did with that paper code backup. You now have a fully functional PIVX mobile wallet. Pretty easy in the end, actually. Why don't I give you a tour of the wallet so you can get familiar with things? The first thing here is a quick way to add an address to your address book. You just scan their QR code and give them a name. I'll show you the address book in just a little bit. For now, this thing next to that is how you get to your address. Click it and you will be brought to a page where you can see your QR code and the matching address that you can copy, paste, and send to people. If we go back to the wallet screen, we can click the send button down in the bottom right here. Why don't I show you a little transaction? I'll send some PIV that I put in this wallet to another wallet that I have. I paste in the address and set the amount I want to send. If the wallet tells you that you don't have enough money to complete the transaction, take the amount you see on the screen off the send amount. This is because the wallet requires a 0.0001 transaction fee. This is much cheaper than the exchanges, but you have to account for it here. Keep in mind, this is at the time of posting this video. The fee may have changed by the time you are watching this. I ended up having to do this, as you can see in the second frame here. You can see I sent a little less than the original 0.98 PIV that you saw in the first frame. Also at the top, see this transaction ID. Don't confuse that with an address. That ID is used to find transactions on the blockchain. It can be useful for proving that someone was paid. Now I click confirm and pop in my PIN code. Just like that, my transaction is complete. Now those are the essential features. But let me show you a few small things before we conclude our lesson for the day. If you click this menu at the top left, you can see some options. You might also see something like this. I took this shot from when I had just installed the wallet. The wallets can take a little bit to sync up to the network. If you see this, you won't be able to make any transactions yet, so just wait until it goes away. If we click address book, we can save addresses we use a lot for convenience. If I put that address I sent to earlier here, I can give it a name like me. Then when I send something, I can type in me and then click the drop-down entry and it will fill the code in for me. Pretty convenient. If we open that side menu again, we can go to the settings and change options. You can also come here to make new backups or restore an old one. And that's about it. That is all you need to know about the PIVX mobile wallet. There's a few other small features and such, but I'll leave you to explore those on your own. Thanks for tuning in, and I will catch you in the next class.